Hello everyone, today I'll be giving a quick walkthrough of a tutorial of COMSOL Multiphysics. This is a sample model that was taken from the website right here, and the PDF can be downloaded from here and easily followed. Basically, it will be a better understanding of the workflow of the software. Our goal is to apply the module to simulate a simple heat transfer problem in solids, which can be a starting point for more complex models in the future. Just to preface the entire tutorial, what I'd like to go through are the four steps of COMSOL simulation. The first step is to choose the space dimension you are working in, the types of physics you want to study. The second is to build your object. You can either import it in the software itself, or import it or build it in the software itself. Define the unions as well as the material you study. Third, we want to define the physics you want to study, the domains and boundaries, as well as the mesh, how coarse or how fine you want it to be. And finally, we will perform our study. This can result in presenting different types of data in graphs, tables, and whatever kind of data you would like to present and evaluate. So the problem we're going to do is defined in the PowerPoint. So consider a domain or a block of material of 0.6 by 1 meter, and it has these different type of boundary conditions. The left boundary is insulated, the lower boundary is kept at 100 degrees C. The upper and right boundaries are convecting to 0 degrees C with a given heat transfer coefficient, and the thermal conductivity of the material is also given. So to also, the simulation results, what we're looking for is something that looks like this. And we're also trying to determine at a target location of this location, the temperature has to be close to this number, 18.25. So now let's begin. So this is the COMSOL software that we have. Everybody has the 5.4 version. Just double click. It'll take a few seconds to load. And when you are working with COMSOL, make sure that you are either on campus or connected to the university VPN if you are off campus. And we do have an academic class kit license, which allows 30 concurrent users. So if you are trying to log in and the license manager told you right now the license is full, just wait some time and to log in again later. So this is, when you open the software, this is what you all see. So to begin, let's click Model Wizard and then choose 2D. And because we're working with a heat transfer problem, so if you don't have the recently used because you are just starting, just click on Heat Transfer and choose Heat Transfer in Solids. And then click Add. Now Study. And now we'll perform a stationary study. So basically, the variables will not change over the time. And I'll click down. Now your windows will pop up. This is the basic workflow of COMSOL Multiphysics. So we'll have the global definitions. You can define parameters and material properties here. The components. In the components, you need to define geometry, the material properties, and the physics. And then you will need to mesh, finally study, and then the results. So to begin, we'll create our geometry. So the geometry, click on the geometry. To create a rectangle, you can either go to geometry and then click on the rectangle, or go to geometry here and right click, click rectangle. And we want a width of 0.6 and a height of 1. And then click build all objects. So now let's define our boundary conditions, which is under the heat transfer in solids. And remember, we want the left boundary to be insulated, the lower boundary to be kept at a constant temperature, and the upper and right boundaries to be convecting. So you can do this either by right click here or just go to physics and the boundaries. Click on temperature. So we want the lower boundary to be at a constant temperature of 100. Instead of Kelvin, we want degrees C. Okay. And then we want another boundary type, heat flux, for the top and right boundaries. And the convective heat flux with a heat transfer coefficient of 750. And for the external temperature, we want 0 degrees C. Now, if you look at the thermal insulation, so by default, the whole domain is insulated. And everything else, if you define something different, will be overridden. So finally, in the solid, let's define the thermal conductivity, and we'll have user defined of 52. So now we define all the boundaries. Let's go to mesh, and here we'll just click mapped. So you can either go to here and then click mapped here, or right click here. Right? Mapped. And we will just use the default settings and then click build all. If you want to make the mesh coarser or finer, you can always change the settings here. Now we move to study. So move to study, you can go to here, and then click compute, which is the equal sign here. In a few seconds, this simulation is completed, and we'll see the thermal gradient here. Okay, that's exactly what we are expecting. Now we can define a specific point and find out the temperature in there. And for this tutorial, we'll define the temperature at a point of 0.6 by 0.2. So first we want to make a cut. So go to data sets, or you can go to result here, and cut point 2D. And we want this to be 0.6 and 0.2. And you click plot, now you can see the location of this point. Now to look at the temperature of this point, you would go to results, and then point evaluation. So on the point evaluation, choose the point that you just cut, and we want to do this in degrees C, and simply hit evaluate. Now you have 18.265. That's exactly what we're looking for. So this completes this tutorial, and I hope this is helpful. Please let me know if you have any questions.